voices.
Well, joining me now is Dr. Paul Stott from the Henry Jackson Centre, who's an expert on terror and security. I'm good to have you with us tonight. Now, of course, these really early stages, the investigation is ongoing. Police have confirmed, though, that this is a terrorist-related arrest. What can we talk about in terms of the police response to this attack?
Well, the police response appears to have been very prompt. This is obviously an incident right in the city centre, in one of Manchester's main shopping centres. So PCSOs were there pretty much at the start. The individual then seems to have been running amok, and eventually to have been brought down, tasered, I think, outside the shopping centre. So it's a type of thing that the police drill for, that they practice for, and indeed they have drilled for and practiced in Greater Manchester before at the Trafford Centre, one of the other big shopping locations. So overall, they seem to have done a very good job.
I mean, if you do look at the location, the Arndale Centre has been targeted before, has been targeted in a terror-related incident. How significant is that?
It may be very significant. We just don't know at this stage. The most likely explanations are either potentially a jihadist attack, or equally somebody with great personal problems who's decided to strike out. There was an incident in Manchester on New Year's Eve where a man shouting about Islamic State stabbed several people. And in that case, although it certainly appeared that was an Islamist attack, the person was detained under the Mental Health Act. The case hasn't gone to court. So there's that potential as well.
But as you say, it could be related to anything. It could be an international terrorist relation, or indeed domestic, or have some kind of mental health kind of links as well. In terms of the location, again, it's literally just hundreds of yards away from that Manchester terror attack a couple of years ago.
It brings back very bad memories. I think after London, Manchester has suffered more than any other city from terrorist attacks. The reality is that terrorists are drawn to areas where large numbers of people are going to be, and where they know they're going to get maximum publicity for carrying out attacks. So whilst, if this is a terrorist attack, whilst we should be horrified, we shouldn't necessarily be shocked. Very often terrorism does develop a sort of pattern, a sort of rat-a-tat-tat. And, you know, we've seen recently the terrorist attack in Paris where Islamists killed four police officers. We saw a far-right attack in eastern Germany this week. So, unfortunately, that type of rhythm does sometimes develop, which was the problem we saw in 2017.